तीन में कर दे, आपको मान लो ये पढ़ाएंगे इसको हटाओ।
वो तो ठीक है, प्रोफेसर बराबर पता लगेगा ना, ये ऐसे थोड़ी रहता है।
ये ऐसे ही रहता था।
Namaste everyone. It is my great pleasure and honor to welcome each one of you to our 30th World Yoga Festival and the 9th International Day of Yoga celebrations. This is the 24th year we are hosting this event in New York City, and this is the second time we are going to host World Yoga Asana Sports Championship. I want to greet all the special guests, speakers, performers, viewers, supporters, all the trustees and volunteers who work hard for this 1 month long event. We have online event and offline event. So here I like to invite our chief of guest, that is Dr. Varun Jeph, is the Deputy Consul General of India at the Consulate General of India in New York. He is a medical graduate. He is a career diplomat with over a decade of experience in the Indian Foreign Service. He has served in different capacities in the Indian Embassy in Myanmar and Indian High Commission in Malaysia. In between his overseas assignments, Dr. Varun Jeph served in New Delhi at the Ministry of External Affairs and was involved in administration and human resource management of India's diplomatic corps. He joined the Consul General of India in New York in September 2021. So since 2021, I know him very well. He's a very close friend of me, very friendly with all the members. So soon he meet. Without delay, I want to invite our beloved Deputy Consul General, Dr. Varun Jeph. Ambassador, floor is for you.
Guru Dileepji, elected officials, yoga masters, spiritual and religious leaders, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning to you all. And a very warm namaskar to all of you. Guru Dileepji, thank you very much for this gracious invitation. It is indeed a delight and an honor for me and for the consulate to be joining this opening ceremony for the 30th World Yoga Festival and also for the 9th International Day of Yoga celebrations. As many of you may know, we are celebrating 75 years of India's independence, our Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. And that makes this session today and this month-long event even that much more special for us. Our compliments and our congratulations to Guru Dileepji and to the world yoga community for the splendid work and for the far-reaching impact that you and your organization and all the yoga enthusiasts have had in celebrating yoga, in promoting yoga, and taking the benefits of yoga across the world, be it the good physical fitness, be it spiritual well-being, be it mental health, and wellness. So you have achieved a lot. So our compliments to you for that. And I also thank you for bringing together so many yoga connoisseurs, preachers, practitioners, practitioners of yoga from different walks of life, from different fields, as we celebrate yoga, which is an invaluable gift of ancient Indian tradition to the world. And when we talk of togetherness, togetherness is also the underlying message behind yoga. Because yoga, as many of you may know, it is a Sanskrit word, which essentially means unison, means connection. And unison of mind and body, unison of man and nature, and a connect, coming togetherness of coming together of mankind and universe. And it also helps us to live in harmony with each other, with our fellow human beings, with our planet, with our nature. And it is that inner harmony then that leads to world peace. So indeed a lot that yoga and through you that yoga is contributing to the world over. United Nations, we are in New York, the city of the United Nations. And even UN has endorsed that yoga provides a holistic approach to health and well-being. And of course, it also strikes a balance between different aspects of life. India holds the G20 presidency for this year. And the motto of our presidency is One Earth, One Family, One Future. And we, all of us coming together here today, also shows the appeal and the power of yoga, of bringing people together from all walks of life, people of different colors, races, even nationalities. There are people who have joined us today from different parts of the world to celebrate this invaluable gift. And we at the Consulate, we take pride in partnering with World Yoga Community in this initiative. And besides today's event, there are a series of events that the Consulate is organizing in this month in the run-up to the International Day of Yoga on 21st of June. On 21st, we would be celebrating yoga at the Times Square. Guru Dileepji and his team, they have been joining us in those events. We invite you all also to join us on the 21st at 11:30 at Times Square. We would also be celebrating yoga on the US side of Niagara Falls. Traditionally, it's been celebrated on the Canadian side, but last year we took the initiative of celebrating it on the US side. We would be again organizing a similar event there. And I would also like to share with you all that besides these, every Thursday, and today happens to be a Thursday, the 1st of June, every Thursday in the Consulate, every Thursday evening, we organize yoga and meditation classes. So you're all welcome to join us for those classes, for discussion on yoga, how to do meditation. It is something that many of our colleagues, my colleagues, many of our friends have benefited from. So I invite you all to join us for that. I would also like to tell you that our Prime Minister, last year, he gave a clarion call of life. Life essentially meaning lifestyle for the environment. It essentially means adopting healthy lifestyle, individuals making difference in preserving, protecting our environment, our nature. For example, moving away from plastics. Let's use recyclable bags. Let's use paper bags. Let's use cloth bags. Let's switch to bamboo toothpaste, moving away from the plastics. It is these small things that you and me, when we adopt in our lives, when our families adopt, we can see the difference in the world. So that would be one appeal that I make to all of you on this occasion. And of course, we see the social strife around us. We see violence across the world. And therefore, it is extremely important that we live in harmony with our nature, with our planet, with our environment, and not only to ensure peace for us, for the mankind, but also so that we leave behind a sustainable planet, a healthy living space for our future generations. And yoga is one very simple, but yet very powerful way of achieving that. So let's practice yoga. Let's do more of yoga. Let's promote yoga, celebrate yoga. Let's make it part of our lives. Let's lead a healthy life, a peaceful life. And let's be a part of this holistic health revolution that the world yoga community is leading. And so with those words, I would once again like to thank Guru Dileepji and everybody who's joined us for this session. And I look forward to the discussion, to the exposition and this session. Thank you so very much. Namaskar.
Thank you, Dr. Jeph, for blessing us with these opening remarks. For us, it's a great blessing, Indian Consulate always supporting us. A long time since 2000, we put different programs as the Consulate. I'm so happy we are going to have so many events, physical events. We have a yoga cruise coming up next week, weekend. The resolution is coming up. So many things are going on. I'm so happy. So please say thank you to our Consulate and all the staff and the Consulate.
Thank you.
I like to invite, first I'll invite Ambassador Anwarul Chowdhury. He has to, thereafter Assemblyman will speak. So
Thank you.
Ambassador is a senior diplomat at the United Nations. He was part of so many committees. He is the man of peace, culture of peace. He brought at the UN, all the NGOs love him. He's a former Under Secretary General at the UN. He was the ambassador of Bangladesh too. A long time, around 23 years. Yeah, friends, long. I'll always say he's my mentor. Thank you, Ambassador. Floor is for you.
Thank you, Guru. Thank you, Dileep. To me, you continue to be Dileep always. And we go way back. And I must say that my blessings and congratulations to all of you for this 30th World Yoga Festival and also the 9th in New York City. And I would commend Vice Consul Varun Jeph for his comments. It's wonderful, and he has articulated the thoughts behind this festival, thought behind the international community joining in this effort by India. And I believe that this is a wonderful opening speaker, and I will join in sharing all his thoughts in this occasion. But main thing that I believe is for yoga is the unifying factor in bringing in international community, as we see in the United Nations, together. And that is very important. And it's not only for human beings, but it is the environment, the flora and the fauna of the world coming together and to be engaged in preserving each other. And that is the biggest sentiment behind yoga. And I believe that this is a thing for both mind and body. And so we are together in this, and I apologize. Guru Dileep knows that I have to leave at 10:30 for something very important for my body. So I will thank you again for giving me this opportunity to wish you well. I have done in the many times in the past, and I will continue as long as I'm here to support you and bless you with my prayers. Thank you.
I just put the four of us on the screen, Ambassador Anwarul Chowdhury and Dr. Karim Jeph, and the Assemblyman Honorable Nader Sayegh. So our Assemblyman is going to propose the resolution for Yoga Day at the New York State Assembly on this coming Monday. So last year he made it Assembly, and the Senate, it was passed. So we are looking for to have a bill very soon in New York State and the federal government too. So I know Assemblyman will help 100% with his full heart. He's from the District 90 in Yonkers. I always go there. We have so many programs, yoga programs, interfaith programs, cultural, Diwali, like many of them. And last week we had a wonderful celebration from his country at the Yonkers City Hall. So without delay, I want to invite Assemblyman Nader Sayegh. Floor is for you.
Thank you very much. Again, I join with the Deputy Consul General words of wisdom and really a terrific critique of this event and what the purpose and meaning of it is. And listening to the words of Ambassador Chowdhury, I think we all share the common agenda of distributing and promoting more peaceful coexistence awareness here in our state and our nation and world. And many of us have committed so much time and worthy time, like my dear friend Guru Dileepji, who makes it his life to really travel the world and travel through community to community and really promote the message and the wellness and the benefits of yoga. But it goes beyond yoga. It really goes into the concept and issue of interfaith dialogue and awareness and peace. And it's unfortunate. Many of us, although we may practice different religions, whether we practice Judaism, Hinduism, or Buddhism, or Christianity, or Islam, and so forth, we recognize that although there may be some differences, as members of the human race, we're a majority, or in my opinion, over 90% common. Common agendas, common goals, where we value family, we value traditional values, we value the best for our worth, our world. As the ambassador said, and the council general, you know, we look at protecting Mother Earth. And as a member of the New York State Assembly, I've been blessed to be part of a majority government here in New York that has taken a very strong lead in doing environmental protection legislation, climate control, and really making sure that we as a people begin to look at what brings us together as a global community. You know, we're beyond the days of years ago where I live in India, I live in Jordan, I live in the USA, and I have my own local concerns, and I shouldn't be concerned about what happens in other parts of the world. We're recognizing that we've become, through the internet, through global media, through the communications, openness of communications, a global society. And as a global society, we can communicate more efficiently. We can begin to look at what makes us better as human beings, what makes our world cleaner and healthier, and makes the air we breathe cleaner. We spoke earlier about plastics, and it's amazing how in a number of years, short years, our oceans are cleaner, our waterways, our parks are cleaner because of the plastic ban, plastic bag ban. Now we're looking for a conversion to clean energy. And hopefully, you know, we can make the world safer for all of us. As a legislator from New York, you know, largely through my affiliation with my dear friend, Guru Dileepji, we looked at many aspects. For example, something as simple as promoting cricket, the sport of cricket in the United States. We helped promote the sport in the USA, in Westchester County, where I represent. And now we have in America 8 teams, you know, where now it's becoming a popular sport. Why is that important? Because as we celebrate the sports of different people around the world, we celebrate the religions, you know, we celebrate different religions in schools in America, we have holidays. And why is it that with growing community of South Asians and other peoples from all over the world that we don't celebrate, for example, Diwali? And now there's a movement. There's a movement where in certain school districts in New York City and Yonkers and elsewhere, we're beginning to recognize that our makeup of our community is very diversified, and we need to reflect that in our designation of holidays, for example. And very important for me, interfaith dialogue. And Guru and I attended many events over the years, multicultural events from all over the community in the world that celebrate the beauty of the different cultures. And here in America, we used to refer to ourselves as a melting pot because of the different cultures and peoples. But as I spoke to the Guri, my new perception of that is we're not a melting pot. We are really a salad bowl. We're a salad bowl that makes this great nation where every part of the salad, the tomato has its culture, identity, and looks and color, and the potato and whatever else goes in your salad has a different identity, but together it becomes a salad. And that's what America is. And that's really what our world is. So I join in not only celebrating interfaith dialogue, because with all the conflicts that are going around the world and people that are suffering, the sad part about this is much of it has to do with religious differences. You know, when they talk about differences between religious conflicts and people that are suffering and dying because of religious ideology, it's really a shame. And religions, when you look at the core of all religions, believe in peace, believe in coexistence, and believe in respect for each other and fellow mankind. So it takes organizations like we have. And that's why I'm so grateful to participate and join in this dialogue. And even if each and every one of us in the hats we wear and the roles we play expands and makes the message of whole coexistence more widespread and more acceptable in any circle we are, whether it's speaking to our families, our co-workers, people we have dialogue or business with, that's what makes this message go out. So I'm glad that this Monday, as Guru said, we'll have again a resolution celebrating World Yoga Day in New York State. And as an educator, we also already started, you know, one of my staff members on the assembly, Chandra Sukhdeo, has already been doing yoga classes in the Yonkers public school system. And the Guru and I have spoken about not only expanding awareness and celebrating yoga, but to really begin to look at ways to put it into practice. And the way to put it into practice is to recognize, as the Council General stated, the importance of yoga, the wellness aspects of it, emotional and social and physical, and the health wellness awareness of it. And therefore, by doing yoga classes and promoting yoga in public schools, we become a healthier people. So today, I'm honored to be on this panel. I have an assembly session presently going on. I'm in Albany, New York, but I wanted to make sure I took special time to share in this great opening and wish you, Guru, and everybody on this telecast a very joyous, joyous yoga holiday, and may it continue for not only many years, but decades as we help and make our world safer, healthier, and happier for all. Thank you very much.
I am so happy you were able to join today and bless the occasion with your beautiful words. And I want to thank all the assembly members and senators, because Diwali holiday is going to happen. So that will be a big thing for all the Asians, especially Indians and other neighboring countries, because we want to have Diwali celebration. Definitely it is a Hindu holiday and the cultural holiday to celebrate Asian culture. So I'm so happy you are part of that moment. So thank you.
Thank you very much. Have a good day, and hopefully we'll see everyone soon. I see Dr. Kaufman, Iman Muhammad, and many of our friends. God bless.
We'll have our yoga day celebration in your office too, as usual.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it. So now I like to invite Subhadev. I know he has to teach a class. Subhadev, but from Yoga Vidya, he is here. So he is one of the senior most yoga teacher in Europe, and he is from the Shivananda tradition. We never met, but we are friends. I never been in his ashram, but one day soon I come there. And he is so friendly with everyone, and he is living yoga. It's not really teach, living yoga. So he, for sure.
Namaste. Guten Tag. Om Namah Shivaya. Welcome. I'm very happy to be able to be here to this grand opening of World Yoga Festival for the World Yoga Community, International Day of Yoga. Yoga means harmony. Yoga means union. Yoga means coming together. And I'm very happy to see here human beings from different religious backgrounds. You see human beings from different countries, different social backgrounds, young and old. And I think that is something that yoga can contribute in this world. Whenever people come together and practice yoga together, afterwards they smile at each other, they feel connected towards each other. In our ashram here, we have people from many different backgrounds. They have not seen each other before. And then they come together, and after the first yoga class, hearts open and one feels connected. And so it is good to practice yoga, and it's good to invite people from different backgrounds, whatever the background is. And in that way, we will have more peace and more harmony in this world. And as there are many speakers here, I wanted to make it short, but what is important also is to just say some words of blessings from meaning. May all beings attain peace and harmony. May all beings live in peace and harmony. May all beings spread peace and harmony. Om, om, om. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Om shanti, shanti, shanti. May there be peace, peace in the heart of all beings, peace between human beings, peace with the Mother Earth and the whole creation. And thank you very much, Guru Dileepji. Well, we've met a few times online and we feel connected, and you definitely should come to visit our ashram one day.
Thank you. So you are in Germany now, right?
Right, yes, now I'm in Germany.
Yeah, so we'll have another section for longer talk.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I'm going to show a short video. Most of you already saw it, but some people are new. The last 50 years of work, I want to show it a little bit. It was a long journey, 50 years plus. And a new video is coming end of this month, the last 5 years programs. So now I like to invite our angel voice, Michelle Dallefay. She is our NGO representative at the United Nations.
Thank you for inviting me, Guruji. Yes, it's the balance of mind, body, and spirit to bring about peace and love. And here's a song, two songs that say...
Which song you're going to sing?
Yes. Beautiful. Everything is beautiful. Everything is beautiful in its own way, like a starry summer night or snow-covered winter's day. Everybody's beautiful in their own way, under God's heaven the world's gonna find a way. There is none so blind as one who will not see. We must not close our mind, we must let our thoughts be free. Every hour of every day, the world's getting a little bit older. We must realize that beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder. 'Cause everything is beautiful in its own way, like a starry summer night and a snow-covered winter's day. Everybody's beautiful in their own way, under God's heaven the world's gonna find a way. You're beautiful, yes, you're beautiful, as you feel, as you feel, as you feel.
That is a good one, Misha.
Thank you. Thank you, Guruji.
That's good. So I'm going to invite Grandmother Patricia. They're starting all the prayers. Grandmother Patricia, floor is free.
Thank you, Guruji. I have been practicing yoga since 1977, fortunately. And also, I have participated in the New York City World Yoga Festivals in the past. A warm heart-to-heart greeting and hug from my fireplace to the hearth of your home, my spiritual family, and all of my relatives. There is inclusiveness in this esoteric ceremonial language. The traditional introduction for me is that to tell you that I'm born of the Mississippi band of Choctaw and into the Tachini and Kiaani authentic medicine people of the Dene nations of this indigenous land. I acknowledge our unifying principles in the yoga tradition through our holy people's sacred language and words. I affirm the spiritual oneness that we call Hojo of all people in every land and every language. the yin, the ne, the yajr, and chlin. It's an affirmation of an eternal truth. I'm a precious child of Creator within creation, simultaneously within Hojo, and so is everyone equally within the natural order laws of holiness and wholeness. And I give gratitude first to the task that was given to me by my own late father when he said to me at a very young age, quote, undo the thinking that caused us so much violence and suffering. And I see yoga as a universal practice doing just such a task collectively. Thus, my lifetime work is to advocate for cross-cultural, intergenerational, and inclusive wellness restoration, as we are all born humane beings. And at the very basic level of equality, our body is of the Mother Earth, and fire is our temperature, and we're about 72% water. And then there's the perfect peace and love in our in-breath and out-breath from the Creator's sacred breath. So life is, the message I understand from this is that life is not all take and it is not all give. There is a reciprocity in taking care of ourselves as precious earth, water, fire, and air, and stewarding the earth, water, and fire, and air to take care of us. And that's what the indigenous people of this land did for generations and centuries. We must balance these four elements within us and around us. While I'm affirming that this is our footing, it's a temporary existence on the physical plane, on our life journey. But we are all interrelated. We're interconnected within the spiritual planes in a realistic and practical, holistic practice. And it is with gratitude that we acknowledge this context, the container of Hojo, the oneness that we're all existing within our eternal self in the eternal now. We did not make it so. It is so. So let us dismantle and undo the erroneous beliefs about yoga by educating the benefits through uniting in world yoga practices. My own understanding of yoga is that the sacred self identity is in union. Our sacred self identity is within a holy existence of an everlasting sacred being, that we express this holiness and live as humane beings in our thinking, in our planning, in our decision-making, in our practical and realistic decisions and actions that do embody love and peace within us, around us. The indigenous wisdom teachings that I know speak of this reciprocity and mutuality and complementary and collaboration, beginning with procreation, is to undo the male dominance and female submission and restore a healthy helping within us and between us. We're called to use our sacred self intellect, our conscience, and our moral reasoning. Let us pay attention to our decision making and make them win-win, constructive, and life affirming for those outcomes. Thus, in celebrating our eternal existence with the perfect peace and love of Creator, within creation, let us also use our voice in the prayers and the chants in this festival to manifest unity and peace among humanity and peace in the world. Let us use our power within to have power with each other to eliminate that need for power over that is erroneous will to power when we have access to the will to love and the will to good. Let us inspire everyone to realize their true self-identity and join our spiritual humane family in celebrating yoga that teaches us to embody love and peace within us and around us. Hojo nahasli, hojo nahasli, hojo nahasli, hojo nahasli, ahyaha. Thank you, Shikhe Shudane, my spiritual family, and all my relatives.
Thank you, Grandmother Patricia and Davis. You are the strong Native American leader in our community. And I always think about our Ligia, Bishop Ligia. She introduced us, you know, so many years back in Bronx. That's where we met. So I hope you'll be coming to the Parliament of World Religion and visit at the UN, because I can get a pass for you. Okay. Thank you for blessing us with Native American prayers and thoughts and wisdom. Appreciate it. Now I'm going to invite my longtime friend, His Holiness Logesh Muniji, who's a doctorate person. Where is he? I'm just looking at. Ah, here's here, my brother. Unmute yourself. Yeah. He's very active in the interreligious, interfaith dialogue around the globe. And he's going to organize an event in New Jersey in June 17, and he's coming to all of the events in New York and Washington. So many yoga events are coming up. We did so many events together in India, in US. We are going to travel together very soon. My brother, Ajaria Logesh Maharaj, floor is for you.
Thank you, my dear Dileep Guruji. This is 30th Yoga World Festival and 9th International Yoga Day. Yoga is the process which makes the soul realize the divine. Only a healthy person can achieve prosperity and peace. Is also related to our state of mind. Peace of mind is possible through yoga and meditation. For peace, prosperity, and harmony in the world, it is necessary to make yoga and wellness universal. Many global problems can be solved by introducing yoga in education system. By introducing yoga right from the beginning in our education system, best individual society and world can be formed. Yoga should be part of lifestyle for complete and balanced development. Bhagavan Rishabh to Bhagavan Mahavira, ideal of all are there is yoga mudra. Indian scholar Sri Veerchand Raghavji Gandhi promoted yoga in America long back. I am thankful to Guru Dileepji. You are a great job in USA. मैं आपका बहुत-बहुत भारत की धरती से अभिनंदन करता हूं और गुरु दिलीप जी केवल अमेरिका में नहीं भारत में भी जब आते हैं तब भी वो इतनी ही दौड़ लगाए रहते हैं इंटरफेथ डायलॉग के लिए योगा के लिए हमारी संस्कृति के प्रमोशन के लिए बहुत-बहुत धन्यवाद थैंक यू वेरी मच
Thank you, Ajariji. I know Hindi is the very fluent for you. But our crowd is different. Some are Spanish, some are English. But at least you made it very well. I am so happy you joined. So see you very soon in New York City again.
Yeah. I invite you all members in 17th June in New Jersey edition, very big world peace summit.
Great. So next, I like to invite my longtime friend, that is Ravi Vaishnav Shiva Ajariyarji. He's a main person, do all the religious activities, leading the religious activities, and go to all the interfaith programs in New York State and the city. He's all over the city. And he's from the Ganesh Temple. He'll explain the temple's history and all the stuff. And for me, it's a big attachment towards that temple because of our Swami Guruji Maharaj. He was the person put the foundation stone in the beginning part, and I was part of the foundation ceremony for the new flat post. I was part of it. And long time, 23 years, more than 23 years friendship. Without delay, I want to invite him to invoke the ceremony with the Hindu prayers and come. Greetings. Thank you.
Namaste and thank you all for inviting me. It's my privilege and honor to be part of this movement led by Dileep Guruji, whose full time is dedicated to yoga. We all know yoga is an ancient treasure of Indian tradition. And it's a kind of spiritual discipline, an art, as well as science that focuses on bringing harmony between our mind and body, our thought and action, the harmony between the human and the nature, of course, also health and well-being. And it emphasizes on experiencing the sense of oneness with ourselves, the world, and its nature. And thereby, it obviously enhances our consciousness. Every ancient rishis or saints or sages or gurus or acharyas had crafted their yogic culture as the core way of their life. I myself hail from a Shaiva Siddhantic tradition and adapt agamic principles. The agama, which is basically divided into four bhaga, like charya, kriya, yoga, and jnana. The charya part is basically a theoretical part and referred as tantra, and kriya, yoga, and jnana part as successive stage in spiritual unfoldment. The yoga that we practice are known as prasada yoga. Of course, we also include Patanjali's ashtanga yoga, kriya yoga. Even though every agama, well, there are 28 agamas and 207 upagamas, all the agamas emphasize on yoga pada. And in fact, one of the mula agama, that one of the 28 agama itself is named as Yogaja Agama, wherein the focus is fully on yoga. And its very first verse states, Kaila Shashikare Ramye Tami Karha Niketane Yoga Sanasya Chardvastvam Vame Gauri Samayutham Sada Shiva Swarupam Yat Tam Prabhuncha Sravano Viduhu Deva Deva Mahadeva Lokanata Jagat Guru Aksharot Patti Kinnata Agamot Patti Kim Shiva Bhaktur Marhasi Devesha Yat Anugrahabhagaham. Like that, it goes on. So the focus is fully on yoga in this Yogaja Agama. Similarly, there is also another agama called Sarva Jnanottara Agama. So Sarva Agama, Sarva Jnanottara Agama, which describes about The 72,000 nadis are the nerves. That's out of which there are 10 significant nadis or nerves, and its basic functionality is those nadis, including Ida, Pingala, Sushumna, Gandhari, Asti Jiva, Pusha, Yasha, Alampusha, Guhu, and Sangini. So these 10 nadis are very important out of 72,000. Of course, also it talks about the achievement of 8 siddhis. We call it as Ashtama Siddhi, whether it is Anima, or Mahima, Garima, Lahima, Prapti, Prakamya, Ishitva, and Vasitva, like that. Of course, it will take time if I keep explaining it. And also talks about 10 different kind of pranas and its functionality, which includes prana, apana, samana, udhana, vyana, naga, kurma, grikara, Devadatta and Dhananjaya, like that, it goes on. Of course, we also follow the Patanjali's eight angas. That's why it's called as Ashtanga. Whether it is Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. So like that, yoga is part and parcel of every rituals that we do in the temple, following the agamic principles. Most of the basic rules are same across tradition, whether we do worship at temple or an individual practices it. But the application by each one of them are customized by the implementing acharyas like us and like Guru Dileepji and all. So my understanding of yoga in this way, it is a philosophy, it is a process, it is a discipline, it's a practice for the purpose of realization of divine consciousness. Obviously, the Atmajnana and Parajnana. And of course, we insist that one need to get a Diksha or initiation to even practice Yoga Abhyasa. So, because our father says like Charya, Kriya, Yoga, Jnana, finally the Moksha. So, without crossing the Yoga and Jnana, you can't even think about Moksha or the liberation. So, that's about it. I wish to conclude with a verse in Sanskrit. Dyau shantihi antarikshagum shantihi prithivi shantihi apas shantihi oshadhaya shantihi vanaspataya shantihi vishve deva shantihi brahma shantihi sarvagum shantihi shantireva shantihi sama shantiredhi om shanti shanti shantihi arihi om. Namaste and thank you Guru Dileepji for giving me the opportunity.
Thank you Dileepji for joining and giving an introduction of the yogic philosophy.
Yes.
And the wonderful prayers. So we'll have a separate section to have a discussion.
Yes.
I'll be in touch with you very soon. I'll come to the temple.
Thank you.
So happy you joined.
Thank you. Namaste.
Before inviting Remy Alapo, I'm going to show a short video from our 25th anniversary of the World Yoga Festival in Goa. Thank you. So now I like to invite Dr. Remy Alapo for a short prayer and a message.
Namaste, everyone. Peace and blessings to you all. Thank you, Guruji, and everyone at your World Yoga Community. It's a pleasure to see you here again this year, the opening ceremony of the World Yoga event. And I wish you all the best. May peace prevail in your communities and in your homes. Let us continue to foster peace and unity with one another through learning about yogic practices, and also keeping in mind that each and every one of us is responsible for our actions. The actions that we take today are the actions that future generations will emulate. With this, I leave you with a short prayer that may all be well with you. May peace remain in your homes, in your hearts, and may the light of God be the divinity in each and every one of you. May God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Remy. I know you are teaching tonight, right?
Yes.
The colleague. So we'll be in touch. So
yes.
We'll have discussions coming days. And I'll call you in the afternoon, okay?
Sure.
So I'm going to invite Reverend Shangur. He is one of the interfaith ministers at the Integral Institute. Integral Institute is a long time relationship with us because Swami Sachidananda from Shivananda Ashram, and he was so close with the Rabbi Gelbman and Swami Bhua. Then I spent time with Swami Sachidananda. So I have a family relationship with them. So he has a good group of interfaith committee where I am serving in that committee. Without delay, I want to invite Reverend Shankar. Bruce, the floor is for you.
Thank you, Guru Dileepji. And greetings to everyone. I'm humbled by the group that's here and how knowledgeable and wise and dedicated you all are. So thank you for continuing to serve this way. And thank you, Guru Dileepji, for all the world yoga work that you do, bringing yoga, the path of light, to the world. Many of you know Master Shivananda from Rishikesh, and my guru, Swami Sachidananda, found his guru in Shivananda. And Shivananda said to Sachidananda, go to America. They need a lot of help. And so he brought in the 60s, 1960s, he brought in integral yoga to the United States. Swami Bhua was a close friend, as Guru Dileepji said. And we have integral yoga organizations throughout the country. And we have a wonderful ashram near Charlottesville, Virginia. You can see the Lotus Temple there. If anyone is near Charlottesville, the town we're in is called Yogaville. And if you have any proximity to that place, reach out to Guru Dileepji, reach out to me, and we'll make sure you get a warm welcome there. Both the ambassador and the assemblyman said something beautiful about the unifying effects of yoga. And look at the diversity of those of us here, right? That's such great evidence of it. In integral yoga, we've adopted the term truth is one, paths are many. It was a way of indicating, right, that we're all ultimately going to the same place, to that same God realization of our divine self, and we'll take different roads to get there, but we still could walk together. I think the best that I can offer is a couple of Sanskrit prayers. I'll say them in Sanskrit and then also translate it. And then just, I'll say it now. The wonderful thing about yoga is it's a way of life, right? It's a way of life. No matter what your spiritual practice is, no matter what your religion is, yoga is a way of life to go deeper into the mysteries of our own religions. And that's one of the reasons that I've been so grateful, right, to have been exposed to yoga. Om. Om. Om karam bindu samyuktam nityam jayanti yoginaha kamadam bokshadam shaiva om karayan namo namaha. Om united with the source on which the yogis ever dwell grants desires and liberation. Salutations to the Omkaram. Please bless this yoga festival with great success. Om Namah Shivaya Gurave Sachidananda Murtaye Nishprapanjaya Shantaye Nidalambaya Tejase. The Guru's auspiciousness, embodiment of truth, knowledge, bliss. Salutations to the one who is beyond the worlds, peaceful, independent, and radiant. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. For the well-being and the realization of everyone here today. Asato ma satgamaya, tamasho ma jyotir gamaya, mrityo ma amritam gamaya. Om shanti, shanti, shanti. Lead us from unreal to real. Lead us from darkness to light. Lead us from the fear of death to knowledge of our immortality. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. May the entire universe be filled with peace and joy, love and light. May the light of truth overcome all darkness. Victory to that light. Jai Shri Sadguru Maharaj Ki. Jai. Jai Guru Dileepji.
Jai Guru Shankaraji. I'm so happy you brought that background. It was awesome. I love that place. I'm so happy you were able to join today, even last minute. When I went to India for 5 months, I was not able to come on time back to New York. I had to bring everything together very fast. So we have discussion groups upcoming days. So I'll connect with all the people so we can have discussions on this subject. Thank you for your great blessing and joining us.
Okay.
Now I'm going to invite Reverend Susan McCaw. Where is she? Ah, here is this. His advisor at the Value of Community. He's in New York. He's a student of Rabbi Gelman. My longtime supporter and a mentor. We did a wonderful yoga festival at the Indian Consulate in 2007 in order to announce the International Day of Yoga Plans. And here it is, Reverend Susana. Floor is for you.
Namaste. The light of God in me honors, acknowledges, bows before the light of God in each and every one of you. Before I go on, I really want to express on behalf of all of us our gratitude to Guruji. Guruji, 50 years of joining people in peace, in yoga, in love, in light. I think we all stand in a little bit of awe. You know, I have this theory that at the end of your life, you know, when we go to the other side, you bring a peace, whoever you connect with in love, you know, you bring that with you. You have connected with thousands and thousands and thousands of people. You have enriched our lives. And I'm just very, very grateful to you, Guruji. I think, I know we all are. I was introduced to yoga when I was 21 and I read Autobiography of a Yogi by Paramahansa Yogananda. And it blew me away and I wanted to know more and more. And I started practicing yoga. And in my book, Joining Hands and Hearts, that featured 14 religions, I spoke about Hinduism and my love of it. And I remember my publisher said, I love this chapter. And I said, because it reflects my love of Hinduism. Yoga comes from the word, the root word, to yoke, to join, to unite. And that's what we're doing here. And every night I pray. I pray on my knees, not because I think I'm holy, but it puts me in a holy place. And every night I pray with gratitude. So I list the things, I think many of us do this. Do other people here do this? You list the things you're grateful for before you go to bed, all the things you are grateful for that day. And today I will list this yoga festival and all of you that I'm so grateful for. And I also pray for the world. I pray for those I know who are sick, those I know who are lost, and for peace in the world. And I think prayer, it seems old fashioned, but it's very, very important. I deal with a lot of young people and they think prayer is giving up power. It is not. It is summoning power. It is not something outside of us. It is something inside of us, connecting us with the universe, with the power that sustains and creates us. So I just want to say thank you. Thank you, Guruji. Thank you to each and every one of you. Each and one of you is a beautiful light dedicated to peace and love and goodness. And we need more of that in the world. And so Guruji asked me to write a prayer. So I wrote a prayer. So let us bow our heads, please. In the spirit of love, compassion and unity, we call out the God of many names, creator and sustainer of the universe. Fill our hearts with love and our minds with wisdom as we come together to pray for the world. Let each of us in our own tradition, whether Hindu, Jewish, Christian, Muslim, Buddhist, Sikh, Sufi, Indigenous, Baha'i, Taoist, Jain, Zoroastrian, and all the other spiritual paths that lead to peace. We come here today knowing that we are part of an interconnected web of life, sacred beyond all measure. May we respect our differences as we seek our common ground, as we're doing here today. Each of us working towards the good of the world. Let us rejoice in the sublime beauty of the diversity that you have created. We recognize that there is hurt and sorrow, terrible deeds that confound us, and destructive actions for which we can find no justification. Yet we also see untold good, people that work every day for the benefit of all mankind as the people here today. We affirm that good. We affirm your good. Give us the strength to overcome any inertia, sadness, or fear that invades us
during difficult times. And when we recognize a weariness in our bones and in our hearts, we call upon divine strength and guidance so that we may become the best version of ourselves. Help us be the goodness and change that we seek in this world. And as we affirm this and renew these goals in our hearts, let us today all say, Amen, Amin, Om Shanti, Aho, Ashe. God bless each and every one of you. And thank you, Guruji.
So did you say in Italian too?
What?
You say in Italian. That'll be fun, you know. We need different languages.
Yeah.
Thank you, Reverend Susida, for joining and giving a blessing and the message. So we'll meet very soon in the city. We'll plan it and we're going to have a lunch or dinner for our group as a part of this event, maybe in Sharanabad or somewhere. So I'll be in touch with you, okay?
That would be wonderful.
I'm going to invite my friend from CRNGOs at the United Nations, and she always helps me when I am traveling. She do my work and always part of our events. A wonderful monk. She's a Buddhist chaplain at the NYU Global Spiritual Life and Religious Life at Columbia University. Currently, she is a co-chair of the Committee of Religious NGOs at the United Nations. Without delay, I want to invite Reverend Doyen Park. Flourish for you.
Greetings of peace. It is my joy and honor to be with you all today. And first and foremost, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to Guru Dileepji and his dedicated team for putting this program together. So when I saw the flyer, this time announcing the 30th World Yoga Festival, it truly struck me. You know, we all know that undertaking something for 3 decades is no easy task. So it takes tremendous effort, clear vision, and unwavering commitment. So I would like to thank, you know, Guru Dileepji and all your people for your, you know, continuous dedication. In the midst of global conflicts, political tensions, social inequality, environmental degradation, economic instability, religious and cultural divides, and mental health issues, and all these things that we're going through as a challenges. So in the midst of all these challenges, the importance of cultivating and nurturing peace and harmony cannot be overstated. And as a Buddhist practitioner, I can say that Buddhism is deeply rooted in profound aspiration for peace. A peace that goes beyond the mere absence of conflict and resonates throughout every facet of our existence. And this peace blossoms from cultivating inner tranquility, compassion, and understanding. And I believe these qualities align with the very essence of yoga practice. So we say when we find peace within ourselves, we can extend it into the world around us. And in Buddhism, the pursuit of peace is not merely an individual effort. It also has to be a collective responsibility. We are encouraged to engage in constructive dialogue, to seek common ground with sincerity, and to embrace diversity with respect and open-mindedness. By coming together in interfaith kind of gatherings such as this, we forge bridges of understanding, recognizing the shared values that underpin our diverse traditions. So let us remember that peace and harmony are not static states, meaning that it's a dynamic process that requires constant nurturing and engagement. So we must actively cultivate peace within ourselves, within our families, and within our communities. And by practicing mindfulness, embracing compassion, and extending kindness, we create ripples of peace that can permeate our surroundings and touching the lives of others and radiating outwards. And in closing, I would like to offer a Buddhist chant called the Four Great Vows. And I will read in English first, and then I can chant in Korean with rhythm. The Four Great Vows. Sentient beings are numberless. We vow to save them. Delusions are endless. We vow to eliminate them. Teachings are infinite. We vow to learn them. Supreme enlightenment is inconceivable. We vow to attain it. 중생무변 서원도 번뇌무진 서원단 법문무량 서원아 불도 무사 서원상. Thank you.
Thank you, Reverend Doyen. You did in your language, Korean language. I know only a few words, and yeah, I show you a few things. So we have few groups joining here. They are part of the Korean groups. And next one is they are the group of children. They are from different families, international families. They are going to perform songs. So Dorian and our team is going to host our annual gathering at the Baha'i Center next to the UN this Monday at 12 p.m. to 3 p.m. So those who want to be part of the UN NGOs, those who are affiliated with the UN, you can apply for the membership, or you can have a temporary membership with those who are not part of the UN. So thank you, Doyen. I know you had to do other things for joining. I hope to see you on Monday. You're thinking different things. So now we have somebody from America, that is Reverend Francis Marshall and team from Heavenly USA. They are going to perform a group song. Let me, my heavenly USA.
Good morning, good morning.
Good morning.
Namaste. Namaste, everybody. Happy World Yoga Festival. This is an incredible opportunity. Thank you so much. Reverend Francis isn't here, but my name is Hannah Bush. I'm the choir director for Heavenly USA, and Francis Marsal is the leader, the director of the program. And yeah, we are a program of young people from a gap year actually called Generation Peace Academy. It's where young people after high school, they take time to grow their faith, relationship with God, sense of who they are, and learn how they can make a positive impact in the world. Also building character and leadership skills. And yeah, this specific group right here, we travel all around America, connecting to different denominations and interfaith groups, encouraging unity among all people. And yeah, actually everybody here, we're races, we're all from all around the world, mixed from all around the world. Like I'm half Japanese, half American. We have Filipino, we have people from Ghana, we have people from everywhere, Ecuador, everywhere. So we're children of mixed families and international families, and trying to share this message of peace and unity. So we really feel we connect to your heart, and the unity starts with our own mind and body united through yoga that you're sharing. Yes, and we're so grateful to be with our good friend Guruji, who taught us yoga and meditation. And so we're so happy to celebrate together with you. So please enjoy. We're going to start with this song called Unity.
Unity, saving the people. Happy World Yoga Festival!
So we have one more song, right? So after little while. So we'll have a yoga session next week in baritone, okay?
Wow, yay, thank you.
So now I want to invite my brother, Reverend Imam Arif Haski, for a Muslim prayer and a message. How are you, Imam?
Good morning, Guru, my brother, yeah. Your Excellency.
And about your two organizations name too. And every Friday he has an interfaith, interreligious gathering at 3 p.m. New York time. Those who like to join, please join. I met Imam through our All Faith Seminary International. We were together in New Yorker Hotel for an interreligious program organized by UPF, Universal Peace Federation. Since that day, we are friends and family. Flores, sorry.
Thanks much, Your Excellency, my brother, Guru, Reverend Dr. Dileepji. Greetings with peace, salam, shalom, shanti, namaste, sat sri akal, and peace. Dear brother, Your Excellency, Guru, that is a great honor to know you, as the whole world know you, so that is great honor of mine as well. As you said that we met at the New Yorker Hotel, that was a blessing to meet such a wonderful man and share the room first time we met. And ever since, I feel you like my biological brother. So it is my great pleasure and honor to be with you to celebrate your 30th annual World Yoga Festival and your 50 years of activities in yoga and interfaith. I'm blessed to hear such a wonderful statement of those wonderful people, speakers before me. So we know who we're talking about. We know who's our brother, Guru. We know who's his team that they're working for betterment for all people. And I congratulate you on this day for your activities and your team. May God Almighty continue to love you and bless you and your team with all the best for you in serving entire humanity. May God expand our brotherhood to touch all hearts in the world to be part of our family. May God help us to help those in need, homeless and less fortunate everywhere. May God purify our hearts with yoga and our spirit, other spiritual and ritual prayers. Yoga is not only prayer, yoga is also a way of life. The more you do yoga, the less you have to see a doctor for your physical therapies or for your mental disorders. Yoga will help you as well, ritual and spiritual prayers. I ask God Almighty for your health. And I thank him for bringing you from India, even though we know how busy you were there, establishing so many events, doing good for our Indian people and us who was following you. May God have those Indian people hearts to continue to follow you through all over America and the world. And may God guide us all to be part of peacefully establishing justice and peace everywhere. Amen. Thank you again. Again, God bless you.
Thank you, Imam Arif. We are going to have discussion groups with the different religious groups, spiritual groups, experts from yoga and prostates upcoming days. So I'll connect with you. We'll make our separate event. Okay. Then we can have more time. Thank you for joining. I know you waited a long time.
Thank you very much. We will.
Now I like to invite, let me see, Morgana Sito. She is the global trustee of the URI. She's from Europe. Morgana, please unmute yourself. Yeah.
Hello. So it's wonderful to see you all. It's been a long time, actually, hasn't it? But I've always enjoyed joining in with the world. I think last year you also had 30 days, so it's beautiful to join you all. I don't think I'll be able to join every day, but I will definitely try. So greetings from the Netherlands. I just like to remind you, I think most of you probably know, but on Sunday is going to be full moon. It's going to be full moon. So as is always a time when I think everybody can join bathing in the light of the moon, as we say. So I wish everybody also on Sunday a wonderful, wonderful full moon. And let's all join together in, as I say, in the moonlight. Greetings from the Netherlands.
Thank you. Thank you for joining. So we'll have our separate event with the URI team this month. Yeah. Thanks.
Thank you.
So I'll ask, let me see who is here. Dr. Krupal Singh Ji.
Thank you, Guruji. Namaste, Sat Sri Akal. Good morning to all of you. First of all, I like to appreciate the energy which you provide, Guruji, for getting together, organizing this 30th World Yoga Festival and so many other activities. This is really amazing. You're a blessed man, and it's very nice to know you. And from you, this radiant energy helps us all. So may God, Vairu, always keep you healthy, and your team, which helped you in whatever capacities it is possible to continue this great work. You know, Sikh tradition is based on Guru Nanak. Guru Nanak's teachings are Ek Omkar. That means oneness. And it goes on saying Sat Naam, which means the truest of the true, the eternal, is the Ek Omkar, and who is the Karta Purakh, creator of everything. Everything. And it is not only creator, but also lives in what he has created within his creation. And it's timeless, and it has no hate, and it is fearless, and it's all source of wisdom for all of us. So to that eternal reality, Guru Nanak says, you know, focus and remember whatever things you are doing all day long, including your activities such as yoga. And this yoga really means to connect with the creator. And so this meditation is an extremely important phenomena as far as the Sikh tradition is concerned. And we do that by remembering the qualities of the God. We call him Satnam, we can call Allah, we can call Jehovah, any name you can. The idea is the essence is the same, which is Ek Omkar. So having said that, beloved Lord, please, we know you with many names, and thank you for providing this energy and this get together for all of us. And give your blessings for the successful implementation of these ideas which come out of this meeting and debates, so that we can always live in harmony, celebrate your presence in our lives, and in all our environments and paying attention to what you have created, loving our neighbors like ourselves. And I concluded with Guru Nanak's prayer, Nanak Naam Chardhi Kala Tere Pani Sarvatamala. Focusing on these qualities wells up the energy according to Guru Nanak's teachings, and then we direct it toward the welfare, universal welfare, which includes us all. Thank you for this chance, and again, congratulations. Vairika Khalsa Vai Fate. Amen.
Thank you for joining and bringing the Sikh message. Really have a separate event like last year we had. So I'll connect with you, just inform your team.
You'll thank
have
you.
Yoga and Sikhism. Good to thank have you. Different subjects in. Now I like to show this Nahoko Sugiyama's dance. She made it, I think, with Michelle or somebody. Let me see which one is it. Great. Now I'd like to invite Sri Gandhikota Harimaji from the Sarvadharma Sai Center in New Jersey and his advisor to the Valio community. Harimaji, floor is for you. Can you hear? I cannot hear you. May have to go out and come back again. No, I cannot hear. Just go out from the meeting and come back again. Yeah, that's better. So let me see. The Mirta Bado here. Mirta Bado.
Guruji, can I say a few words? Just TK.
Yeah.
Hello.
TK. Okay. TK can go.
Is that okay now?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Sorry. I'm still in a gas station, you know, service station of Honda. So anyway, but I just wanted to congratulate, first of all.
Foundation.
Uh-huh. Yes. Can you hear me okay?
Yes.
I guess. Oh, great, great. At least now it's a little quieter here, so I can say a few words. And yeah, first of all, congratulations for your great accomplishment. Every year it's like a 30th, I mean, which is wonderful to see, been doing that 30 years. You only started like when you're like 3 years old. You look much still energy, I can feel, you know. So. But then it's yeah amazing how much the time goes fast, and then it's actually the you know the as you always participate Hiroshima Nagasaki ceremony, and then this is my 30th anniversary time of the Hiroshima Nagasaki in August too, so I feel like the time flies so quickly, so and then I think you might feel the same way. But time is very precious. And I believe, you know, every year is very important time. And I kind of feel that way nowadays. And so I congratulate your yoga festival, I would like to, you know, remind us of the, you know, importance of the right now that we are living. And so we should do the best that we can do for taking care of any of the things that's happening in the world as well as yourself and so forth. So that's what's happening, I feel, especially like today, all of a sudden I have to go to bring the car to the station. That's the, you know, you never know what happened to that moment. And, but then every moment is a one accumulation of all the virtues, everything. And I like to really congratulate Guruji, connect to everyone here and bringing all those people together, energy together, and wisdom together, compassion together. And those are very important part of it. And we need to have more things like this instead of fighting each other. You know, of course, the situation of Ukraine and so forth going on. And some, you know, governmental people try to fight, you know, bringing other as enemies and so forth. But I think it's very important to have such efforts to make more friends instead of enemies, and try to protect from somebody from the outsiders or whatever, the stranger. So I think that what you have been doing is a great thing, and connect people and trust, you know, humanity, and then trust the value of the humanity that we have. So we all can do a lot of good things instead of bringing other people as enemies, and, you know, like somebody who hates something. But rather, we should have all those quality of goodness. And I believe that yoga traditions, well, Dharmic tradition, basically have the sense of truth, and then, you know, truth, and the people trusting the all living beings. And so that's something that I feel very important for today. So I thank you again for your great efforts to bring us together. And I cannot chant here, so I just wanted to say in Japanese for the little prayer, may all living beings be happy, well, and peaceful. May we all be free from suffering. May we all be free from pain. May we all be free from attachment, from greed, anger, and ignorance. May we all attain ultimate happiness and peace of enlightenment. 願わくはこの孤独をもって平等に支えに施し、同じく菩提心を起こして安楽国にお嬢さん、南無帰仏、南無帰依、法南無帰依、so. Thank you. Take care. Congratulations again. Best wishes.
Thank you. Take care. We need a separate event with all the Buddhist group in this month. We'll plan it. Thank you.
Yeah. Would like to.
Now I like to invite Michelle thereafter. Arim is back or? Oh, he's not back. So Michelle will do a song. Thereafter we'll call Mehta Bahadur. If Arim is coming, then we'll call Arim. Michelle, floor is for you.
Thank you. Okay, hello, how are you? Good morning, everyone. But it's me with Michelle.
Hi.
You say, Guruji. I can wait.
Whatever Guruji wants, I'm good. Should I sing now or I can wait?
Yeah. Sing you now. Then we call Arima.
Thank you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring love. Where there is injury or pardon, and where there is doubt, true faith in you. On the master grounds that I may never seek, so much to be consoled. To console, to be understood is to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is despair in life, let me bring. There is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O master grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood.
New song. That is a good one.
Thank you, the channel of your peace. Creator. Thank you.
So I want to let you know because we have 6 more speakers and 2 more songs and 2 videos. So those who speak, go faster. I'll invite Aryamaji. Okay, here is.
Namaste, G. Can you hear me now?
Yes, yes, yes. Good.
Yes, my laptop locked up, so I had to switch to the phone. Anyway, namaste, sisters and brothers. Salutations to you all. I'm an advisor for the Sri Satsai Baba Sarvadharma Service Center in New Jersey. Sarvadharma means all faiths, multi-faith, all names, all forms, and the formless. So it's a great honor and privilege to be here with you for the beginning of the World Yoga Day celebrations in 2023. That sounds almost futuristic. Thank you to Brother Dileepji, I've known for decades, and all the excellent speakers we've had so far. Once again, my apologies for the computer problem. So Brother Dileepji has been working hard for yoga and multi-faith for decades. So I'll start with some sayings of Sri Satsai Baba. There's only one religion, the religion of love. There's only one language, the language of the heart. There's only one caste, the caste of humanity. There's only one law, the law of karma. There's only one God, and he is omnipresent for everyone. So he says, honor all religions. Each is a pathway to God. Hands that help are holier than lips that pray. So now we come to some quotations of Sai Baba on yoga. Yoga is chitta vritti nirodha, the control of all the agitations of consciousness. One who is able to control them is a yogi. God is the Lord of all yogis, Yogishvara. The goal of yoga is union with God, and yoga is open to everyone. Yoga means control of the senses and the concentration of the mind in the unity of all. This is done at various levels. Physical, through yoga asanas, or the, you know, all the exercises that you see, that is not the only yoga. Mental, meditation, and spiritual, through love and service. Hands that help are holier than lips that pray. We must have unity of thought, word, and deed. So everything must conform. Otherwise, we're not faithful to ourselves. The path to union with God is through prema yoga, the yoga of prema, or love. The discipline of love and service alone can lead you to God. The essence is love all, serve all, help ever, hurt never. So the principles of all faiths are satya, truth, dharma, right conduct, shanti, peace, prema, love, ahimsa, nonviolence. So I'll conclude with a prayer. Samastha loka sukhino bhavantu, samastha loka sukhino bhavantu, samastha loka sukhino bhavantu. Om shanti shanti shanti. Thank you, and may God bless all.
Thank you, Aryamaji, for joining. I had a beautiful meeting with the managing director of the Sai Center in India. So I invite him to America to be part of the UN religious group. So let us see. We can do more things.
Yeah. Looking forward to it.
Thank you, thank you. Now I like to invite our heavenly USA because they had to go back to their classes. They're preparing for their exam. Ready, heavenly USA. Unmute yourself.
Hello, this will be our final song. Thank you so much once again for inviting us to this World Yoga Festival. We will sing this song called All the Lands That I Love.
True love!
Thank you for joining.
See you very soon. Have a great, wonderful rest of the festival, everybody. Bye-bye.
Say hello to
him. Say hello who?
Now I am people from the UN NGOs. One is Dr. Padmini Murthy, and the second person is BK Sister Savita here from Bema Umayri. So Padmini Murthy, floor is for you.
Thank you so much. Namaste. Greetings, everybody. Thank you, Dileepji. As usual, you're back, and we've started the yoga celebrations with a bang. And I, as I always say, Dileepji is the energizing bunny because he goes on. And, you know, so what I wanted to say is thank you, Michelle. You and the heavenly youngsters really transported us to another realm. And thank you, everybody, for talking about the spirituality and how yoga puts everybody together. Being a physician and a person of science, yoga has shown to improve the health and well-being. And in this day and age, I just came back from Geneva attending the 75th anniversary of the World Health Assembly. So health is still considered a complete state of social, physical, mental well-being. Well, yoga helps us to attain that. And, you know, being a regular yoga practitioner for almost 8 years, it's addictive. Like if you don't do yoga in the morning, you're like, oh my God, I didn't do something. So I just want to say that having events like these is so good because it brings all of us together. And the last thing I wanted to say before I give it over to our respected Guruji, who's going to hand it over to Sabita Ji, is that it's teamwork. So especially because India, where yoga started, is hosting the G20 this year. India is the presidency of the G20. And I think, and some of us like Denise Carter, our dear friend and colleague, is working on one aspect of C20. I'm working on the health aspect. So I just want to say yoga is the medium which binds us all together. And thank you so much, Dileepji. Again, you're back, as I said. And then it's so good because we are off to a great start. Thank you so much. And look forward to interacting with all of you in person and online. Thank you. Back to you, Dileepji. And I think I kept my time.
I'm glad our team is working for the G20 from the UN group. Good to have that. And our Prime Minister Modi is coming to New York and Washington, D.C. This month. So I'll give the information very soon. Now I'm going to invite BK Sabdaji for your blessings, message, meditation, whatever you like. Then I'll call Dr. Vinarma.
Namaskar, everyone, and Om Shanti. Thank you, Guruji, for this opportunity. And yes, we are blessed that you are the one that is taking the lead on this to take us forward on our yoga celebrations and reminding us of the purpose and the benefit of yoga practices in our life. It's indeed very nice to see many friends today also. In the practice of Raj Yoga, which is what we do, Raj Yoga is actually based on ekta, this word ek, yoga meaning unity, bringing together, uniting, being with one, being in one consciousness. And so this word ek. And so today I would just like to introduce or share with you all five aspects of ek very briefly. One is Eknami, connecting with the one source, having the name of one in our hearts and minds. Another one is Ekagrata, concentration on my inner principles, concentration on my connection and interdependency that I have within myself, with each other, with nature. Another one is Ekant Priya, love for solitude. Finding time every day to go within and connect with our inner core so that that element of unity will be there within myself, which I can then bring out when I come into action with others. Another one is ekras, being in that inner state of constancy and steadiness, from which there is strength and support that will then elevate my awareness, purify my attitude, cleanse my vision, rekindle altruistic actions. And we see that this part of yoga, ekras, is one of the main qualifications if we really want to bring about a world of one humanity or one consciousness. And the other one is economy. What is wealth, or what is real wealth? What generates the future? Wisdom, wealth. And I need to understand how to use the various aspects of wealth in my life. Wealth is not just money, monetary wealth, but wealth could be the wealth of my pure thoughts, the wealth of my pure intent. So the wealth of my wisdom, the wealth of my virtues that I share. So all of this come under wealth, our inner treasures. So holding together these five eight, as I will call them, will help to bring us in unity. And so now for a few seconds, let us reconnect with the very first one, the name of one, Ek Nami. Just in silence, reconnect with our inner core and with the Supreme One. Thank you. And all the best for a wonderful Yoga Day celebration. Om Shanti.
Thank you, Sabdaji, for joining and bringing the teachings of Brahmagumaris. Brahmagumaris is one of the NGO I work partnered more than 35 years. And they are going to host an event at the Central Park, Peace in the Park, every July. We have a celebration, plus all the yoga events at the UN and other places. So let us see. I'll be in touch with you very soon. Thank you, Sabita. I appreciate it. Now, I have to find all the speakers. Let me see. Vinamara. Where is the Dr. Vinamara? Ah, he is here. And Finn, then Nirta, just a minute. Nirta Bado is here. Any other person from the flyer? No, all other people can make a comment after the speakers. Okay, Dr. Vinamra Sharmaji, so now you are in different university, right? So how is the new place?
Very good. Very so blessed to be here. Namaste, Guruji, and vice admiral to all the speakers here for the 30th World Yoga Festival.
Sound is cutting out. I think that's a line problem.
Mahavir Gurunaji, who is the spirit of Masin Nazi, who is the initiator of the Hatha Yoga tradition. So Hatha Yoga is also one of the tradition of yoga, in which the word Hatha is the means that it's, the word Hatha is derived from the two words like Ha and Tha. It means the union of sun and the moon. So that Hatha means that the yoga brings a balance between the sun and the moon. So Ayuri Gopnaji is also the ruler of the Nath, considered one to be as Nath movies. So Nath is one of the popular Indian traditions, which is combining together the establishment with this and the Hachirma together. So I'm so blessed to be here. So I understood the yoga when I came in contact with the your contact, because your knowledge, the words you are spreading for the words. So I'm in contact with you and your vision to make a community of throughout the world, each and every corner of the world, like the Basudev Kutumb. So this is your spirits, and this is the true spirit of the yoga. And once again, I'm thankful to you, Guruji, giving me the opportunity. And I'm so blessed.
Thank you, Namaji. Last year, you have 30 days with all the students.
Yes.
So we'll plan something. I'll call you next one. Now I'd like to invite our value community from Argentina team. It's Mr. Tabaro is the director and president there. Mr. Tabaro, unmute yourself.
My phone is closed. Oh, hello everybody, follow over the well. I started greeting you 5 or 10 minutes ago. I will be very short because you are a shorter time. I'm going to tell you that I'm happy to see you again, every one of you. Blessings to all of you. Yoga is union, integration, no discrimination, woman rights, peace, not differences, not colors, not nationalities, not flags. Every color is white. It's okay into yoga. That is my message. And I tell you, Guruji, thank you very much for your guide, because every time I need you, you stay there in order to help me. Anymore, I sent you the link of our video by this chat. Only you can share. Thank you very much to everyone.
You play the video on 11th, right? Our program.
Okay, no problem. Thank you. Blessings. Om Shanti.
So Nilaya, unmute yourself.
Namaste. Are you hearing? It's okay? Did I unmute? Yes. Yes, okay. So namaste everyone, and I wish to share with you my great, this feeling, that this love feeling in my heart, that it rises when I receive so much beauty from all the words, all the thoughts, all the prayers, all the blessings that we've been sharing during this 2 hours here. And thanks to Guruji for making this possible. So this is yoga. I think that what we do is yoga all the time. Like when we wake up in the morning and we feel grateful to be alive, we think life is a miracle. So this miracle that life is, this miracle that brings everything connected, like all the universe, and touches us in our souls, this is yoga. And this is what we do when we come here. So Guruji, it's not just the yoga day. We do the yoga month. June is the yoga month. So the calendar now has this special, like we have the special for the moons, and then we have for yoga. So may we all have a beautiful, wonderful, fabulous, joyful yoga month. Thank you so much, and God bless
yoga month us. To, yoga day to yoga month to yoga year. For us, every moment is yoga moment, you know. I remember a long time back when I mentioned about yoga day plans, people so angry. You want to destroy the yoga movement, that's where they start, you know, even they threatened. But we work with our government, we do very well. Some leaders listened to us, some people didn't listen. After the proclamation, you know, everybody wanted to make a name out of it, enjoy it. Now, and my point is everybody is practicing yoga around the globe. Lot of, you know, millions. That's the best part. For yogis, we don't need any credit, but we know so many people did hard work to have this yoga day. Now, I like to ask Tosoli Veronica. Unmute yourself.
Namaste. You listen to me?
Yeah.
Namaste, Guruji. Thank you so much. Thank you, all of you, for the opportunity to learn of all of you. I'm young in yoga and I learned so much of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, thank you. Dodi Espinosa from Argentina. Mirta, is she part of the Velia community?
Yes, Dodi Espinosa is from Peru.
Oh, Peru, okay.
She doesn't speak English.
She can speak in Spanish, then you can translate.
Dodi puede hablar en español, entonces.
Buenas tardes, buenos días, buenas tardes, no sé qué hora están por allá, con todos, en especial Guruji por la invitación, estoy muy agradecida. Es un honor para mí participar en la apertura del mes del yoga. Quiero decir de que el yoga es algo muy importante para mí y quiero ayudar a las demás personas a conocer este mundo maravilloso, ya que nos enfoca y nos lleva a conocer más allá de lo que generalmente ven nuestros ojos. Particularmente cambió mucho mi vida, cambió mucho mi manera de pensar, de ver las cosas, ¿no? Se lo agradezco mucho a mi maestra, Mirta Bardó, es mi maestra. Estoy muy agradecida con esto por la invitación. Muchas gracias.
Muchas gracias. Yes, Mirta Bardó. Okay. Suna Wong from SWPL. Yeah.
Yes, thank you so very much for this wonderful time for this World Yoga Festival. And this is the very beginning, the day number one. And there were really great words that we were able to share with this how much we want this peace. And then through yoga, we are able to make it happen. And we always really appreciate Guru Dileepji for leading all of this community with really good inspiration and always so active with not only this within the yoga community, but all of these communities in and outside New York. And we are always so grateful. And yes, I'm going to pick up some more yoga and more meditation, a little more throughout today and then more. Thank you so much.
A healthy body will make a healthy mind. A healthy body and mind will make a healthy soul. That's the way it is. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Amanda Dixon.
Good afternoon. I am also from HWPL as well. So it's been a pleasure to be able to join along with my colleagues. And it's been a fantastic opening ceremony. So congratulations. Thank you so much for allowing us to be able to attend. And it's been such a wonderful event to come together and to have so many people from different cultures and backgrounds and religions really come together in unity and love and peace. And very excited for what is to come. And looking forward to continuing to participate
One of the day we'll do an online program between Value Committee and HWP.
Thank you.
Now I'll invite Sreko Mavrek and Jasbir Bhatia to open your video and unmute yourself.
Hello?
Jasbir Bhatia.
Do you hear me?
Yeah, yes.
But you don't see me because it says that unable to start video. I don't know why. It says because the host has stopped it. So I don't know if you can do something to put a video on.
You want to make any comments or?
Yeah, I just want to congratulate you all, especially you as a host. Moment, I hear a lot of voices.
Sreko talks first, then just we can.
I'm still trying to put the video on, but all right. Anyway, I'm at work. I was a little bit in and out. Huh. I want to congratulate you as a host and to all the participants on this wonderful event. And as just Amanda said before, thank you, Amanda, for your observation that there are so many different people here with different backgrounds from different countries, with different life experiences, that we are all united in those higher goals of yoga as a lifestyle. And that yoga is not just what I used to teach my college students. Yoga is not just a physical practice, but it's something that you know, body, mind, and soul, and it's a way of life that actually enlightens not just ourselves personally, but also our relations to the other people, to the countries, and to the whole world. So I just want you to continue with this great work, and of course, like to present to not only to us, but to the whole world, all those components of yoga that are eventually sometimes overlooked, like eight limbs of yoga and the psychology of yoga that sometimes is not so well presented.
Thank you, thank you.
Thank you.
Tell me, can
I can't, it's not allowing me to open the video.
Oh. Now you can speak.
Okay. All right. Good afternoon. Namaste. Sat Sri Akal. Salam to all people. Thank you, Guruji, for giving me the opportunity to share my thoughts. First of all, I congratulate you for the wonderful work you are doing, bringing people of all faiths together, all walks of life together, into thinking about yoga. Yoga, as we all know, all we have said, is a union, not only just with God, we also say that all humanity is one. The same divine spirit runs through all of us. Therefore, it also means that we unite with all humanity, all people at the same time. To serve God is to serve humanity first. You know, yoga, as Patanjali said, yoga, chitta vritti nirodha, that we have to remove those vrittis, the vikaras, those negativities among our collector, our life, because these are the source of all conflict. The wars and the military conflicts are all because of somebody's ego or somebody's revenge or somebody's this negative thinking. Talk about the war in Ukraine. What is the purpose? If you all understand the true spirit of yoga, there'll be so much peace in this whole world. And I think that's what this program of yours is bringing in, that understanding that we have to, through the principles of yoga, have to raise our consciousness to a higher level of humanity so that this world is a better place to live and enjoy the blessings which God has given, the Mother Nature has given us. So I believe it's a wonderful effort. And I congratulate you heartily for that. Thank you so very much, all of you. Namaste.
Thank you, Bhatiji. So we'll have a separate section for Sikhism and yoga.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'd like to invite Michal de la Faye for our final song. Floor is for you. Unmute yourself.
Sorry for the delay. Thank you again. Peace to all beings. There's a dream I feel so real, so real, all around together.
Songs. Now we'll end up with the one group dance from Nahoko Sugiyama. She sent a clip. Let me see. This dance is good. That was a good one. I didn't realize how it will be. Either she sent the link, I message. But then in 2006, during our yoga festival in Egypt, we had a meditation group inside the Giza pyramid. And after 2 days, I invited all the artists, dancers from that area to do their traditional dance. There's a lot of time people don't like certain dances, but it's all our mind. You know? When you look at it in a positive way, everything art, spiritual, music, dance, you know, singing, any artwork, all are divine. So I'm so happy we all joined today for the 30th anniversary of the World Yoga Festival. And this is our 24th in New York City. And let us see how many we are going to do it. So I'll conclude with a prayer. See. Oh, oh. Samasta Sugino Bhavandu Yoga Samasta Sugino Bhavandu Yoga Samasta Sugino Bhavandu Om Chandi Chandi Chandi. Thank you everyone for joining, all the partner sponsors. See you upcoming days.